again, everybody. This is Blue Eyes for another GIMP tutorial. Recently, I have not been able to make any tutorials for personal reasons. I'm trying to make one today. It's not one I was planning on making, because right now I'm not with internet. So let's get started. We're going to make a banner. First thing we're going to do is create the banner. Go to File, New, go to Template. We're going to go down to where it says web banner. Let's do 728x90. And you notice that it's pretty small in size. Well, banners ain't going to be a big thing. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Layers, Transparency, and Add Alpha. Then I'm going to go to Edit, and let's see, where is it? Clear. That way it give me the alpha channel as a background. So you probably notice I had a couple things already pulled up. These are the things I'm going to add to this banner. First, I'm going to have to resize things. Let's make it smaller there. And move that out of the way for time. If you have noticed, that main picture there is too big for that banner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually copy this, go to the edit, and copy, lower that down, and I'm going to actually go to edit and paste. Then you see the whole thing ain't there. Correct. So I'm going to have to resize. There are a couple ways I could resize it. I could go to Layers and Scale Layer. I'm going to show you a different way, the way I do it. I go to your toolbox, and in the first column before Icon Down, which is the Scale tool, I click it. Then I click on this. Move this out of my way. And I'm going to have to knock this stuff out of my way. So, right here is the size of the banner. And if you notice on this big picture, it got in corners, top, left, bottom, and right. You got little boxes. Well, you can take these boxes and drag it. To whatever size you need. And we'll compress that picture down. Like so. And bring this box over and hit scale. Now, got that. Now, let's zoom in. Yes, it stretched. Can't really help that because what we are working with. Well, we're going to work on this here now. But before we do, there's a couple things I want to do here. One thing, let me move that over to the side. Go back here. Oh, I forgot to anchor this. To anchor a picture, you go to layers and anchor. Now that has set that picture to the background. Now I'm gonna make a new layer. I already covered different on layers. So if you go back and watch the second video, you will get a little bit better understanding of layers. So I'm gonna go to layer, new layer, or I could go over to my layer panels and click on the little sheet of paper here and hit OK. So I just made a new layer of the size of that banner. Now I'm going to take this and I'm going to hit copy on it. Then I'm going to make sure that new layer is selected and go down to hit paste. Now same deal. This time it's bigger than my background, so I'm gonna make the background a little bit smaller. Now I go over here, hit my scale tool, click on it, and it's still too big. All I'm going to do is get it roughly in size where I can scale back up. And this time I want this smaller. Now if I click on the circle here in center, I can drag. Hit scale. And I'm going to go to anchor under layers and anchor that. Now we got one on there. I'm going to make another one over here, but I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. So what I'm going to do is click on this layer and I'm going to duplicate. Now I got the same thing over here. So I'm gonna take this, take my little four-way arrows, which is the move tool. I'm gonna make sure I'm on the cut, the red, somewhere's on the layer. Like I prefer it on the color. And that way I can just drag. Okay, now I just moved. Now you're probably wondering over to 17. Well, first I'm going to resize that to that image. I'm going to go to the layer, auto crop. Now I'm going to resize again. I just need to move it over just a little bit. And hit scale. There you go. Now you ain't gonna be able to read the words on this, which the words ain't really important. It's just I want to get the symbol. Now I'm gonna add some fonts into this. So I'm gonna click on the font, the big A. And I'm gonna actually change the color. Red. Now I'm going to select Defined. Sorry about that. And so where is it? I will go over how to install fonts and stuff once I get my internet back. This one particular font that I'm looking for was given to me. Big Hoss, which is, this is his logo that I'm using. I'm making this banner for him. So I'm going to just type in here. I'm just clicking there, and I'm going to type. And you're probably wondering, that's too small to read. Well, let's enlarge it. So, I'm going to go to the size in the tool property. Now, I ain't going to make it very big because I'm adding more to this. Now, I'm going to click on my move tool. I'm going to move it to where I want it. And I'm going to add my other. And move it. And I'm going to write something else. And I'm going to take my move tool, and I'm going to actually grab top portion here, move it up. There. Now, I can actually go back and click on the paint tool and let's see. Word team speak. I'm going to change colors on it. I'm going to make it blue. I'm going to zoom in 200%. Yeah. You've been hotspot, I'm going to change to a different color. Let's go with a maroon. Paint maroon. And make half the pad back. Now let's see how that actually look. Actually, let's go with, I'm going to try something, I'm going to try a pattern. I'm going to change the pattern for the other part. Let's see. Let's see how that looks. It's pretty good to me. Yeah, let's do team speed same way. Using pattern. Let's see. That's 200. No, that don't look right. Let's try this. Oops. Well, I'm going to do that. I'm going to edit and undo. That ain't gonna work. Blend in too much. I'm just trying different things, see how things look. I'd rather have a blue. Okay, let's go with that. Well, now I'm going to save what I got. So I'm going to make two different saves. I'm going to go with save as. Which I'm going to make a GIMP file where I can change it later if I need to. Now I'm gonna hit save. Now I'm gonna save it and we'll have to export as. Now I'm gonna use the same name but change the destination. I mean, not destination, but a file. I don't use JPEG, but okay, that's all I'm going to do for right now. So I want to thank you for coming out and watching, and stay tuned for another episode as soon as I can.